Hey guys, what I'm doing here is I'm building a work area in my garage, which is desperately needed. I don't have room or I'm not organized. We just moved here earlier this year and we just built this garage, or had it built, I should say, earlier this year. And I finally got time to where I can build a work area here. So what I've done is I put up the studs and I still have a few more I'm gonna finish up and I'll show you that in a second. I'm gonna put some electrical outlets here and over here and a couple of light switches. I'm gonna put some plywood up against here and I'm gonna be building a workbench, kind of an L shape going against or the wall here and over here. So, and then later I'm gonna put cabinets up here in the future. But I'll show you what I'm doing now. All right guys, what I'm gonna do now is finish up the rest of the studs here. The studs are 9 feet tall to that top beam. These were 10 foot 2x4s, so I cut a foot off the end and now it's 9 feet tall. Now, to connect my board to the bottom 2x4, what I did is I already drilled into the concrete and screwed in some concrete screws. So that's all set, so I can't nail these, obviously. So I'm using this Simpson tie, strong tie, a little angle plate here. They'll screw right onto the bottom of the 2x4, and then I can screw them into the other 2x4 on the base there. So I'll show you that in a second. All right, so now we're gonna screw them in. And when you're putting these plates on here, you want to make sure they're pretty flush with the bottom. If it's not, it doesn't have to be perfect. It'll pull its way down. All right, guys, the next thing we're going to do here is we have to counterbore, drill, and then put these self-tapping screws in that'll self-tap right into this beam here. We're going to connect it down at the bottom, like I'm showing you here. And the top also is drilled and counterbored, and the self-tapping screws are in there also. And that's what we're going to do next. All right, what I've been using are these quarter-inch self-tapping screws. I got these at Home Depot. You can pick these up at any hardware store or big box store. These are 2.5 inches long. They'll go through the 2x4 and into that beam. They work really, really good. So yeah, and then also what you want, the head on these here is approximately 1/2 inch. So I got, I think these are spade drills, is what you call them. Got me a 1/2 inch spade drill. Put it at the end of my drill here. Now I can countersink and then drill the holes and then put those self-tapping screws through there. And I'll show you how to do that next. All right, after you put the end on there, the angle plate, we want to flip this around. And now we need to measure from the end 54 1/4 is from the base where the board's going to sit on top of the other 2x4. Up to the middle of that I-beam. It's going to be 54 1/4. So I'm going to measure here 54 1/4. And then to that top one up there, it's 107 1/4 inches. 107 1/4. And you're just going in a little bit, just eyeballing it. You just want to make sure the head goes in below the surface of the board. And do the same thing on the other end. That'll work. Now the next thing we're going to do is we have to drill now. So I'm putting a 1/4-inch drill bit into my drill. And now I'm just going to drill right through. So now you'll be able to put your screw in there and the head will be hidden and it'll look real nice. And you do the same thing to the other side, to the middle. All right, what I've been doing also is I have to put some electrical wires back there. I got some number 12 2 wire that I'm putting for the outlets, and that'll be a 20 amp circuit there. Then I got a 14 3 and a 14 2 because I'm putting some three-way switches. So I can have a light switch on each end of my workbench to control the lights. And so I need somehow to hold these wires in place. And I got these here, which are really nice. And you can pick these up at the big box stores also. And I'll show you how to put these on too. Okay, now I want to flip this back around. And what I've been doing is putting these little plastic wire holders on the inside back here. Okay, so now we're going to measure from the end. It's got to be under 51 inches. So I'm going to start at 51 inches. And one more. So now what we have here is a place for the wires to slip through there and be held up and not, you know, just hang there. And it makes it nice and neat. All right, now we're gonna hang these studs here on the wall. Now you can't see it in the video, but I got these marked already. I've spaced these apart 2 feet because the plywood is obviously 4x8, so they're 4 feet across, and I want the plywood to fall right in the middle of these boards so I can screw into here on each, you know, on each side. So they're 2 feet apart. I got them marked right here. You can't see it, but I got it in pencil. So what I'm gonna do is drill and tap one screw here, and then I'm going to level the board and then connect it, you know, the rest of the bottom and the top. All right, now we gotta level this board, make sure it's nice and straight. All right, now we're gonna connect the 2x4 to the bottom here, but we gotta make sure it's nice and level. So you wanna put your level on there and adjust it how you need it. And once it's level, put this over here. Okay. All right, that's good. Now check your level again. Now we're going to finish up drill and tapping this screw here. There. That's solid. Now we're going to do the top too. The top, I'm doing the same thing as here. Just put your level up against there and start drilling the tapping. Right, now we're going to do the top here. Again, you want to make sure your board is straight. Sometimes these are warped, not sometimes, a lot of times. This one's not too bad. So, let's move this out of the way. Now, I've had problems where these are really warped, so I've been using these little C-clamps here to clamp it, move it where I want it, tighten it down, and then drill and tap these in there, but this one isn't too bad. Check for level. Good. And put the other tap, drill and tap screw in here. Solid. And I'm gonna finish up the rest and then I'll start doing some of the electrical work. All right, what I've done so far is I put all the wires where they're supposed to be. The power is going to come in from the top here, and I got a 14-2 here going to the light switch, and then I got a 14-3 for the carrier going all the way to the other light switch, which is going to go here, So which one? This is the 14-3 here. And then to go back up to the lights, I got back to a 14-2 going up and up out the top in that corner. And then I'm going to put a box up there and I'm going to wire the lights up over here and overhead over here. So anyways, and then for the outlets, I got a 12-2 wire. I'm going to have an outlet here. Power is coming from up there, so I'm going to have an outlet here. I'm going to have another outlet here, another outlet here, another one here, here, and one over here. So that'll be a 20 amp 12-2 wire for my outlets. And then the just for the lights, I got 14 gauge wire. All right, now I'm gonna start putting the sheets. I'm gonna put this up against there and we'll get that going next. All right, I got the walls done and the electrical all done. Now I'm ready to do the workbench. So what's laying on the floor right now, that's going to be the back part of the bench. I'm just going to screw it in there on the floor and then lift it up and put it together as I go. So it's going to be an L shape from here to that corner and that corner out to there. It's basically going to be 8 feet from that corner and 16 feet to here. All right, so let's get started with that. All right, we're gonna start putting these together now. I'm gonna start with the corner, which is a Simpson corner, a strong tie. You can pick these up at Home Depot by the lumber section. They got all different kinds. So in order for this to work right, the distance from the top, this is gonna be the top of the table here, to this strong tie, it's an inch and a half here. And if I were to put my other board here, this is just a scrap piece I'm using. In order for this to line up nice and, you know, flush here, this distance here would be 1.5 inches. So what I'm gonna do is we'll measure here 1.5 inches. There. There's 1.5 inches. So when this goes on there, it should be nice and flush up here at the top, like that. So, and the screws I'm using, the Simpson Strong Ties, they had screws. I found these here that work really, really good. And they look just like the ones that they have, basically. Even the heads are very similar. So anyways, I'm gonna pre-drill the holes because I don't want the boards to crack as I'm drilling into there. So I'm just gonna pre-drill them. And when you find a drill, make sure that the drill diameter is the same size as the minor diameter of the screw, or even a little smaller is better. And when I say minor diameter, I mean not the threads, but on the inside. Okay, need a couple more here. It's always better to pre-drill your holes, that way you less risk of your wood splitting. Okay, and that's the corner. All right, we're gonna be working on one of the, instead of the corner legs, we're gonna be working on the other legs of the bench. And I'm gonna be using these rigid tees here. They're made by Simpson Strong Tie also. What I've been doing is finding the distance out where these have to go from the top in order for this board to be level here at the top. And I'm putting a 24-inch or 2-foot opening on my bench or underneath. So this is going to be the bottom shelf, and of course this is going to be the tabletop here. So basically what I've been doing is, in order for me to be flush here at the top, this edge here is 2.25 inches approximately. And to get a 24-inch opening here, which I gotta move this up. Yeah, let me move this up a little bit. In order to get a 24-inch opening, I have to be, it was 29 3/4 inch. from this edge to the very top here for me to get 24 inches opening here. That's just the way it's got to be, you know. So 29 1/4 and 2 1/4. So we measure this here like that, and we know this at the top here is 2 1/4. And now we drill them in. Actually, I almost forgot. As I said earlier, I like to pre-drill them. That lessens the chance of the wood splitting when you're putting your screws in. There's nothing worse than you're putting something together and everything looks nice and the wood looks nice and you put your screw in there and the wood splits. There we go. Alright, and now we're gonna screw these down. I think my battery's dying. All right, and as you can see here, I started putting it together, and you know, I'm really surprised that these corner braces here, they're a lot stronger than I thought they would be. Plus, once I put the top on and the bottom shelf and screw that in, this is not going nowhere. So I only have the corners screwed in right now, and it's pretty solid. I have yet to screw in the bottom and all this rest of the stuff here. So I'm pretty impressed how strong these things are. All right, what we're gonna be doing now is cutting up some supports. They go from the bottom, where the bottom shelf is, from leg to leg across here like this. I had one cut out already. And it's gonna go here like this. The nice thing about these, I guess they're called T-straps, is there's still enough room here to put screws in for these supports here, which is nice. So I'm gonna put one here and one on the top all the way down. All right, now we're gonna cut our support. So I gotta measure here 21 inches because we have to subtract for the 2x4s on each side. Each 2x4 is 1.5 inches, so that's 3 inches. That's 24 minus 3 is 21. Measure once and cut twice, right? Actually, no. All right, now we're gonna put our supports across the top and the bottom. What I'm gonna be using are these deck screws right here. Get a close up. I put a washer on them, okay, because I mean, that head is not really enough to hold that board, I don't think. But putting a washer on like that, that'll really help hold things together without the head burying into the wood. All right, so, and again, I'm going to drill this out here, but the 2x4 going across here, I'm not gonna pre-drill the 2x4. I really don't have a drill long enough that'll go through here and the other board. So the diameter on the threads on here were about 3/16. So I got me a 3/16 drill. All right, so now we're gonna put our support in here. Now, this isn't rocket science. I mean, eyeballing is good about where you want it. And then we're going to do the same thing on the other side, of course. All right, now we're gonna put our board in there. Now these are, the drill is 3/16, and so is the thread, so it's gonna be a little snug, but that's okay. And the same thing on the other side. All right, and then I'm going to continue on and do that for the rest of them too. All right, what I did here is to hold this 2x4 where I want it and to make sure it's level with where the shelf's going to be here, I put this board on here in a little C-clamp. Now we're going to screw them together. I'll probably tighten that a little bit more. Good. All right, I got this part of the table done, the main structure of it anyways. I'm really impressed though how sturdy these are here, Simpson ties, strong ties. These, on the other hand, are fairly weak, but that's okay because once I put the 3/4 inch plywood on top and 3/4 inch plywood on the bottom, and it's going to be screwed into the top here, it ain't going nowhere. But these wiggle a little bit, but that's because the only thing it's holding it is this piece right here. But I mean, other than that, it's fine. It'll hold it in place. And like I said, once I put the top on and the shelf and screw that all together, this isn't going anywhere. I got my supports going across. It's pretty solid. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna shove this into that corner up along this wall here, and it should end right by that light switch there, or that green line is there. And then I'm gonna build another one, an 8-footer going across it, and then I'm gonna tie them two together, the two tables. And so I'm basically gonna make the same thing, but only an 8-footer over there. And then I'm gonna start putting the top in. All right, now I'm ready to put the shelf on the bottom of the bench. And since it's 24 inches across, and these sheets are 4x8, I'm gonna cut it directly, right, exactly in half. It'll be just a tad smaller than 24 inches because of the blade width, but that's okay. So we're gonna cut this in half now. I already marked it. I got my straight edge measured 24 inches. Straight down, drew a line. And of course, when you're laying it on a table, like I am, make sure you don't cut your table. Make sure your line is off the table. We don't wanna be cutting the table. And another thing you need is your wife helping you hold the board. All right, I just cut the shelves for the bottom here. What we need to do now is cut out a notch in those shelves for the legs. And I'm going to show you how to do that next. All right, this is the piece we're going to be using for the shelf. Now what I need to do here is cut out a notch for the legs. So get yourself a scrap piece of 2x4. Right in the corner, and then just trace out where it's gonna go. Now I gotta cut out the notch for the other leg here. I just measured that, and it starts at 4 feet. You still see me here yet? Okay, at 4 feet, I have another board for leg. And I'll do the same thing on the other side. All cutting these out. All right, now we're gonna start cutting those notches out. Now I'm just using a jigsaw here. And it doesn't have to be perfect, as long as you get the clearance. Check. Yeah, it should clear nicely.
All right, we're gonna see how this fits now. It's good. I'm gonna finish up the rest of them and then we'll work on the top. All right, now we're gonna screw these shelves down. I have some 1 5/8 deck screws and they should work just fine.
All right, I got these bolts here. These are 5/16 bolts for wood. And like I said earlier, I like pre-drilling my holes, especially when you start getting bolts this size and bigger, you're gonna start splitting wood. So what I like to do is find out my minor diameter on the threads. So that would be right in there. So I'm getting around 215. About 220 thousandths, right in that range. So I want to get something smaller, and I happen to have this drill here, which is about 200 thousandths. So it's perfect. It's just slightly smaller than the minor diameter of these threads here. And then on the 2x4, I'm going to use 5/16 because that's what the shank is here on the bolt. And then of course I'm going to use a washer and we're going to connect the workbench to the wall. What I'm going to do now is on the legs, right behind this leg, there's a 2x4 on each leg. So I'm going to put one of those anchor screws here in about here to hold the table up against the wall and have it be part of the wall. That way when I'm working on something, especially if you, when I put a vise on here and I have to torque on something, I don't have the whole table moving on me. So we're gonna get our first drill. Make sure everything's in place. I'm gonna put it about right here. There's one. The other one about here. That was a piece of cake. Now the 5/16, which is the size of the bolt, that's the size of the drill I have here, I only want it to go through the 2x4. So this you have to be a little careful, or what you can do here is mark a piece of tape, put a piece of tape on here for the thickness of the 2x4, that way you don't go plowing all the way through. All right, let's see here. Just put a little piece of tape on there. It'll tell me where to stop. That's it. And now we're gonna screw these in. All right, and now I got my drill ready. What I did is I just got the, I got a regular socket with a 3/8 end on it. That should do it. And we'll put another one here up top. Man, that is solid. That is solid. All right, now we're gonna put our tabletop on, the bench top. I already had these cut. I cut them, and rather than cut them 24 inches, I cut them to 26. I put another extra 2-inch lip on here and on the end in case you want to clamp something. It's a good idea to always do that. So let's put this on. Good. Now we'll put the other side on. Okay, we got one more. All right, now we're ready to screw the tabletop down. And again, I'm using the, what are these, 1 5/8? Yeah, 1 5/8 deck screws. And everything's nice and tight. There. You don't want to miss the board. There you go. All All right, since I can't see the board that's underneath here very well from the top, and I don't want to guess at it, I'm going to measure the 2-inch lip that I have here plus half the 2x4, which is 3/4 of an inch, which gives me 2 3/4. So, all right, I just got my workbench done and I'm really happy with it. It came out solid, better than I thought it was going to come out actually. I'm really surprised with those Simpson strong ties there, the corner ones especially. They really hold, they're really good. Not so much these here, those little T-straps, but you know, once you put your top piece on and bolt that down, it's just as good as those corner ties. So yeah, I'm really happy with it. I made the tabletop a little high, well, higher than normal, I guess, because I figure I'm going to be standing up most of the time doing work on here. And I have a stool I can sit on also. So anyways, like I said, I'm really happy with it. Now I got room to put stuff down here. Work on top. Got plenty of bench space now. I think it's almost 17 feet from that wall to the edge here. So yeah, and in the future I'll probably put cabinets up here or hang some of my tools. So anyways, like I said, I'm real happy with it. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I know it's kind of a lengthy video, but it's kind of hard to pack 6 days, 4 to 6 hours a day of work into a 10-minute video and try and explain everything. But again, hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something from it. And hopefully you can build a nice work area in your garage or a metal building. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I would greatly appreciate it. Thanks.